What is up, ladies and gentlemen? Johnny Boy here, back with a new video, and in today's video I'll be talking about the throwing events in athletics. There are four throwing events in athletics. You have shot put, discus, hammer, and javelin. These are all different implements and they are their own independent discipline, but they share a lot of rules and regulations, which is why I have done them in one video. If you want to learn about the other disciplines in athletics, then I'll leave a link in the description below and on the card in the top right corner. So without further ado, let's get started. This is where they have a metal ball, which is called a shot, and it must be put, not thrown, as far as possible by the athlete, hence the name shot put. The shot must be held and thrown by one hand. It should be held close to their neck or their chin and must remain here until the shot is ready to be released. You're not allowed to take the shot from behind the line of your shoulders, so in other words, you're not allowed to use a throwing motion that you would use in other sports such as baseball. In this event, a heavy metal ball is attached by a wire to a handle. The athlete must hold the handle, spin the whole implement around his or her body, timing the release to launch the hammer as far as possible. This is an event where the disc-shaped object is thrown by the athlete as far as they can. This event, the athlete throws a spear-like object as far as they can. The javelin is made up of three main parts: a hollow shaft, a head, and a cord grip. This is the only event where the athlete is allowed a run-up in order to gain power and momentum before the throw. The javelin must be held by one hand. It must be thrown over the shoulder, or the upper part of the throwing arm shall not be slung or hurled. Non-orthodox styles are not permitted. For the throw to be successful, the javelin must hit the ground from the tip first. If it hits the ground with any other part first, the throw will not count. Here are all the rules and regulations that all these events have in common, starting with the throwing area. For shot put, hammer, and discus, you have a circle that the thrower must throw from, and they're not allowed to step outside of this circle until their throw has been completed. Whichever object they throw, it must land, and only then can they leave the circle from the back half of the circle. In order for any throw to be successful and get measured, it must land in the marked out area, which is triangular in shape and marked out from the throwing circle. Any throws that land outside this area do not count. For discus and hammer, you also have a cage around the circle. This is for the safety of other track users and spectators, as it stops throws in the wrong direction. For javelin, you have a similar field where it's triangular in shape and you must throw within these boundaries. However, the circle is replaced by a runway, which allows the thrower a run up before throwing. But again, you're not allowed to pass the line from which the throw is measured from until the javelin has hit the ground. Each implement is regulated for weight, and here are the weights. If you want to read them, pause the video now. Other regulations include the material used for each implement, the shape and dimensions of each implement, and finally the finish on the surface of each implement. However, I won't bore you with this information, as you do not need to know this to take part or watch the sport. The aim of all four throwing events is to get the furthest distance. The person with the furthest distance wins. The distance thrown is measured from the throwing line to where the implement first impacted the ground. So if it bounces or slides along, the extra distance it gains does not count. In general competition, each athlete commonly has 4 to 6 throws per competition. The athlete with the longest throw at the end of the event wins. In the event of a tie, they will face off each other, and the athlete with the next best effort will win. These are the basic rules and regulations of the four throwing events in athletics. If you have any questions, then comment below. And if you like like the video, hit the like button. If this doesn't sound like your ideal sports, then check out many other sports that I have done, such as weightlifting, swimming, rugby, and many other sports. And also, to stay updated with my latest videos, hit that subscribe button. It will keep you updated with my latest videos. And as usual, ladies and gentlemen, adios.